I scavenged some boards off a bed frame on the curb, and this one is finger jointed and broke right at the joint.
And I thought with the shape of those finger joints, they should be close to the strength of the wood, but maybe not.
And here I've got some more finger joint boards, so let's do some testing to see how strong those joints are. I got a 22 by 22 millimeter specimen in here with the joint right here, and just this little clamp to hold it up so that when the scale tears, it doesn't weigh the specimen.
And that broke partially in the wood and partially on the glue line.
And now that same piece of wood that broke right here without a joint.
So a nice break on this one, and the joint piece was 58% the strength of that one. But I gotta test a lot more samples to get confidence in the results. And on that one it was failing quite a bit on the glue joint. That looks like a mostly glue failure. This one's more of a wood failure, although plenty of glue surface failed here too. Plus, of course, the end grain here, that just failed at the glue line, not the wood. Fairly clean break on that one. Another disappointing strength, although it seems to have failed mostly in the wood. Now tabulating the results, the first four are where I was breaking the joint like this with the fingers in a horizontal position, and those averaged around 100 kilograms breaking force. Next is the ones where I had the fingers in the vertical orientation as I broke it, and those did slightly better, maybe 110, and then these ones are solid breaks, that is no joint, and these all were around 200 kilograms, except for this one, which for some reason failed early. But excluding those ones, I would say the finger joint is only about half as strong as a solid wood, which I find rather disappointing. And now testing this finger joint material, which is a hardwood, but I'm using the same 22 by 22 millimeter profile. Seems largely a glue failure here.
And now testing a strength where there isn't a joint.
That followed the glue line pretty closely. I only did 5 breaks for this material, and this is the different orientations here, and solid was of course stronger, but on this one the joints were about 70% the strength of solid, so that's more in line with my expectations.
And for the next test I cut some 18 by 22 millimeter pieces off of this large panel and breaking it at the joints. So this piece had the grain at kind of a funny direction, and I didn't expect it to do well, and it failed at just 109 kilograms. But it wasn't broke all the way through, so I flipped it over and broke it from the other direction, at which point it went up to 151, because the grain was a bit better going that way.
This next one looks like it wasn't fully seated when it was glued, so I don't expect it to do well.
So this was an interesting failure. I wanted to break it here, and I knew I had the finger joint here, which would get some stress, but much less stress than here, about a third of it. And it broke on the finger joint. Oops.
So because these samples were rectangular, I only tested them in the vertical direction, that is, the finger joint is actually vertical. And these are the joints, and these are the solid pieces, including the one with the bad grain that I then retested. And this one did worst of all, with these only on average about 40% the strength of these.
With the finger joint samples in the softwood doing so poorly, I was wondering if I could just join them better myself,
So I set the table saw to 20 degrees and cut a V into one end of one of my sample pieces and a similar point to the other end and just glued together that one. And I did that with all my broken test pieces that were still long enough. And tabulating the numbers, I added the V joints right here, and these did pretty much as well as the finger joints, although of course not as well as the solid wood. Next, looking at the big panel that I cut apart, I only did two of those, and those actually did much better than the original finger joints that were in there, but again, not nearly as good as solid wood. And for the hardwood panel, my V joints did considerably less well than the finger joints, half as strong as the original, which is kind of in line with the other materials. I tended to be about half of the solid wood strength. So I guess the summary is these finger joints in the softwood were not as strong as I thought they would be in the samples I had, and my V joints were, if anything, better than that. Although in the hardwood, the finger joints, there's one right here, outperformed my V joints. And I wanted to make my own finger joints to compare, and I bought one of these router bits for that, but I haven't had any luck with that, so didn't do that for this video.